some of the largest construction equipment around paves the way for the very thing most of us use every day. Highways. Slip-form pavers are humongous highway laying machines. They do the really big jobs, like building freeways, airports, and canals. The largest of these pavers can lay down a mile of concrete in a single pass. And the biggest of them all is called the Gameco GP4000.
It's a monster machine. It weighs over 180,000 pounds and eats concrete. Most pavers weigh roughly around 100,000 pounds, so it's almost double the weight of a normal concrete paver. The 3500's nickname is the Hog. It's a big machine, a lot of meat, but we call this one El Presidente. The crew named it because it's so big they think it's bigger than life.
Life was tough before this wonder machine paved its way onto the scene. 20 men would be lucky to lay a mile in 2 weeks. But today's monster pavers, a small crew can do a mile of freeway in a day. Carl Carper has worked with pavers for 27 years.
No forms are necessary, so you don't have that extra time and labor to set those forms. This machine, basically, you can see you dump it in on the front of the machine, and it comes out a finished slab on the rear. As the machine progresses, the concrete flows through it, through a pan.
Selecting the shape and size of the section you're paving is no problem with a slip-form paver. Looking for a curved or flat freeway? Fine. Curbs and gutters? You got them. No task is too tough for this road warrior. Making tracks with a monster paver is a slippery business. The machine has vibrators that consolidate the concrete at extremely high speeds, causing the concrete to slip out the back. The largest slip-form pavers can put down pavement 50 feet wide, 2 feet thick, and smooth as a baby's behind.
You, as a riding public, don't normally know much about the paving other than whether it's smooth or not. When you drive on it, you can tell if it's smooth or not. So as a manufacturer and as the contractors using the equipment, they strive really hard to make it as smooth as possible.
It's not just an attempt to keep your coffee from spilling. If a road has too many bumps, the concrete will crumble under the wear. Kevin Coffman and his family have been paving the way in this business for over 30 years.
There's wires set out here, two wires set on each side of the machine with four cylinders and four readings on the machine that hold grit elevation. The elevation is constantly being monitored by the computer and making constant adjustments to keep the pavements on profile. When we're keeping the pavements on profile, that gives us a better ride. We usually get 30 to 40 years out of pavements, and they're trying to extend that lifetime. The longer it lasts, the less they have to go in and maintain it.
The trick to prolonging pavement life is to put rods or dowels in the concrete. This keeps the slabs from rocking and sliding against one another as traffic passes over the top.
A dowel bar is installed at every joint in the paving. A joint in concrete paving is there to control the cracking. Rather than allow this slab to move up and down on each side, they put a bar in that joint, and then as the traffic goes over it, it doesn't allow the vertical separation. the impressive part about this particular machine is that we have an attachment on there that automatically inserts the dowels all in one motion.
When it comes to executing a paving project, it's all about timing and planning ahead. Take too long to make tracks with your concrete mixture, and you're setting yourself up for disaster.
Concrete paving is totally unforgiving. So if you don't do it right the first time, you get a serious problem. If you're supposed to be putting 12 inches of concrete down and you're only getting 11 and a half, then that would be bad news. With the controls that we have on the machine today, the very high-tech controls, computerized, that makes it easy, but you still have to be concerned about it and watch for that. A paver like this, it takes a lot of concrete just so it can keep going. A fear is that something might go wrong. And there's a lot of moving pieces on there, so you can see what would happen if something breaks and you've got all this concrete on the way and some on the ground already. You got to have a lot of courage just to start. So that's what I remember about slip form paving. It's just the gamble you take.
You're working with a perishable product at all time. We have exactly 50 minutes basically to get over the top of the pavements. Or the concrete starts to get a little hard, starts to tear the surface, and then you lose the rideability, you can't seal the surface, and worst case scenario, the concrete has to be removed.
In addition to the pressures of construction, there is physical danger working around these monster machines.
Slip forms are dangerous, very dangerous. All kinds of moving and animated parts. It'll run over you, it'll rip your arm off, it has no mercy. If everybody's working as a team and moving in the right methodical places, nobody gets hurt. Paying attention to what's happening, letting people know where you are on the machine at all times is critical to being safe.
The interstate boom of the 50s and 60s saw slip form pavers reach their prime. But with the interstates complete, by the 70s, pavers were almost extinct. But now, 30 years later, the interstates are aging and big pavers are back, big time. But most experts believe these machines will not get much larger than this.
I don't see that they'll be much bigger simply due to weight controls. If you get it too big, it takes too much time to tear it down so you can haul them. I don't see them getting a lot bigger in size.
It goes to show that while big is beautiful, bigger may not always be best. That's fine, because we like the slip form paver just the size it is. Monstrous. Whether it's boring a tunnel, building a towering skyscraper, hauling molten metal, or paving a six-lane freeway, these monster builders are the powerful tools needed to make a massive construction project mighty easy.